make a horrible mess on an old newspaper.
Well, the last thing he needed was something to make him more cocky, and a victory over Coco Beware certainly did that. But I think in any further competition, whether it be in six-man action or in one-on-one, the Brain is going to be in a whole lot of trouble, because the edict came down from President Jack Tunney that never again will he be allowed to wear that particular outfit inside the squared circle. Must confine himself to the common wrestling gear. He won't be too happy about that, I know. Tama in there now, going to work. Van Horne on the receiving end. Oh, look at that shot. And the tag's made to big guy, Haku. Double slingshot. Reverse knife edges found their mark. Van Horne needs desperately to get over and make the tag to Scott Casey, the veteran on that team. Oh. Reverse crescent kick and then a chop right to the back of the neck. Actually, on the back of the head, right in that external occipital protuberance area. Oh, went downstairs in the breadbasket. Anxious to see whether the Brain is going to try to get a contract signing between his Islanders and the new champions, the new tag team champions, Axe and Smash Demolition. Irish whip and flying elbow. El beauty by Tama. That may be all for Van Horne. Don't. Tama could have had him there, but wanted to dish out a little more punishment. Indeed, WrestleMania 4 was a history-making event. First time ever in the history of professional wrestling that an undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion was crowned via the route of a single elimination tournament. And what a job the Macho Man Randy Savage did, proving to everyone his capabilities, having to really be put to the test four times out of the chute, four times victorious, and now he and Elizabeth have the gold. This one is over, I'm afraid. Haku and Tama victorious. Let's get the official word.
Here are your winners, the Islanders.
Islanders continue their winning ways. Let's go back and take a look. Here it comes. Bombs away. Look at the height on this. He is about 12 to 15 feet high in the air. It is unreal. Right now, courtesy of Coliseum Home Video Cassettes, here are some highlights from the Intercontinental matchup for WrestleMania 4, Beefcake against Hawkey.
All right, hi again, everybody. Here we go with your WrestleMania 4 report in Atlantic City, New Jersey, Trump Plaza, Hotel and Casino, on Sunday, March the 27th. Brutus the Barber Beefcake truly gave the Intercontinental Champion, the Hawkey Tonk Man, a run for his money and his title. By the way, for the most part, Beefcake dominated the early going of that match. And, of course, he was on top of his game, while others seemed to be dozing off.
Can you blame him? A little time.
Can you blame him?
No. What a backdrop that was. Sends him in again for the ride. And there's the sleeper. He's got it right in the center of the ring.
Hawkey Tonk trying to fight his way to the ropes.
He's way out there in the center. He's not going to make it to the ropes.
He's fading. I don't believe it. Luck may have run out on the Hawkey Tonk Man.
A sleeper slapped down by Brutus. And the champion is fading. He's just about out, Jess. Referee checking the arm. Oh, look out. Get the Colonel out of there. Oh, look, and he nailed the referee.
How brilliant that Jimmy Hart. He saw the Hawkey Tonk Man going down with the sleeper, and he's knocked out the referee.
Hawkey Tonk Man deliberately clobbering the referee with his megaphone. In the meantime, the champion, Hawkey, is sound asleep, Jess.
That's right, but so is the referee, Gorilla.
Well, I'm
sure you can't win without a referee's